Hi guys, I'm Shelley. If you want to know more about plastic injection molding, tool making, and machining, you're in the right place, as we are a professional mold manufacturer in China, and we will upload our new videos every week. Just hit the subscribe button and turn on the notifications so you won't miss any of our new videos. Today, I'd like to share with some of very tight tolerance of plastic products we made for Honeywell company. I have to say, some of them are extremely tight. Let's have a look.
Now let's look at the 2D control drawing of Honeywell. As you can see, some dimensions are with the tolerance plus minus 0.005. But when you look at the numbers 17 and 19, there are two dimensions with tolerance plus minus 0.001. Oh my gosh, plus minus 0.001. These two dimensions are extremely tight. And I will let you know in a minute how we made it. Let's look at another 2D control drawing. As you can see, some dimensions are plus minus 0.005 and plus minus 0.003 and plus minus 0.004. And honestly, these dimensions are very tight. Okay, let's look at here. These are some dimensions, plus 0 and minus 0.02. And the other one is plus 0.05 and minus 0, okay? And let's look at this area. This area basically are plus minus 0.005 and some of them plus minus 0.003 and some of them are plus minus 0.002. These are very tight tolerance. Look at this picture. These are some dimensions of plus minus 0.005 and some tolerance of plus minus 0.03 and plus minus 0.002. These are all very tight tolerances. Also, as you can see from the left area, the nose, each of them have to be inspected and checked and filled in our inspection report. As you can see, not only the dimensions we marked, but also the nose from the left area, such as material, surface finishing, ejector pins, and etc. All of them have to be checked and inspected. And all the dimensions have to be in tolerance, otherwise they will reject all the samples. To be honest, the first tool we made for them was a little bit frustrating due to the tight tolerance. And we didn't find out the best way to achieve it. But anyway, in the end, we did it on our great efforts and we found out the best solution through our experience. So how did we make it? The answer is give the video a like. Well, okay, I'm just kidding, but your like is really important to me. The best way to make very tight tolerance of plastic products in our company is to stay metal safe. In other words, you need to make machining allowance at the very beginning. For example, if it's a hole, we need to make hole size a little bit bigger. If it's a post, we need to make the post size a little bit smaller. Then we do inspection for the plastic product after first tour trial. And then we can know how much amount we need to increase or decrease of steel or material. Then we correct the mold according to the report. After correction was finished, we take another tour trial and re-inspect the plastic parts until the tolerance are met with the drawing's requirements. I hope this makes sense, but if you have other good solutions, put it in the comment below so we can share with each other. Honeywell was asking to make empty texture, but some Europe customers prefer VDI texture. Anyway, different customers have different requirements. Also, the tighter of tolerance, the more expensive of mold price. If you want to know more factors that affect tool price, please watch my other videos. There is another thing you need to pay attention is shrinkage rate. Before you machine a mold, you have to check the shrinkage rate you are using is correct. A right shrinkage rate of plastic product is a key for right sizes. If you used a wrong shrinkage rate, you could never ever bring the size into tolerance. As one of my customers had a terrible experience by using wrong shrinkage, which caused him a huge problem for the plastic dimensions. Then how to choose a correct shrinkage for the plastic products? It depends on what kind of plastic material you want to use for your plastic parts. As long as the shrinkage rate is correct, then it would be much easier to correct the dimensions afterwards. If you like my video, please remember to subscribe to my channel, give the video a like, and turn on the notifications so you don't miss any of my other videos. See you next week. Bye!